This tutorial will look at the form settings and confirmation page options in Google Forms. When you open up a Google Form, you will see three main sections. What I call the beginning, or the form settings, the middle, the actual content of your form, and the ending, called the confirmation page. The form settings section is where you tell the form how you want it to behave when somebody arrives at your form. For example, if your account is a part of a Google Ads for Education organization, you can require that organization's login in order to view this form. Basically, you're restricting access to this form to only users within your organization. If you'd like this form accessible by anyone, then you'll need to remove the check from this box. If you can check off this box, then this gives you access to two additional options. The first is to automatically collect the respondent's username. This can come in handy so that you don't have to provide fields in the form itself to collect the respondent's name or username. The second option that becomes available is to allow only one response per person. This can come in handy if you're using your Google Form as an assessment and you would prevent your students from taking the assessment more than once. Regardless of whether your form is public or restricted, you can show a progress bar at the bottom of the form pages, and you have the option to shuffle the question order so that as each person arrives at your form, the question order may not be in the same order. Now let's come down to the confirmation page. The first option gives you a box where you can provide a customized message to greet the people once they finish your form. Next is the option to provide a link to submit another response or retake the form. Notice that this option is currently grayed out because up in the form settings square, I had restricted it to allow only one response per person. Deselecting that box allows me then to show a link to submit another response. This comes in handy if you have multiple users using the same workstation to fill out the form. It makes it easy for them to restart the form. If you'd like to give your respondents access to the results of the form, you can check off this box. And if you'd like the response to be able to edit the responses after submitting, you can check the third box. You can change and configure the form settings and confirmation page at any time. This concludes this tutorial.